What is up, everyone? Pittsburgh White Schwartz back again with another budget deck tech. Today I'm joined by Brian.
It's deck tech time, everybody.
We had requests for more budget decks. We had the good response on our last one that we did for Konosuba. Kaguya just came out, and everybody's talking about the cool, crazy standby door deck, but that deck runs a lot of super expensive cards. And maybe you're looking for something a little bit more on the budget side, just looking to get your feet wet and Weiss. Maybe you like Kaguya, but, you know, prices can be pretty daunting. Daunting when you're getting into any card game, so we wanted to give a perfectly good budget option that has, you know, honestly for the price, a lot of really good tools. And it's going to be Bag Bar in the K level 1 combo and the Bar level 3 Chica. And I'll show the deck list pool here. If you're just here for the deck list, you can grab it. Encore Decks link in the description. Leave a like on the way out, that really helps us out. This time I've included the average price from TCG Player before shipping. So at the time of the recording, if you watch this later, things go up or down, that's why, but the sort of the average price of every card. This deck will run you about $45, well under the cost of a booster box, which was our target. It's always our target with budget decks. We want to make sure you're getting a much higher value than just, you know, 20 random packs of cards, stuff like that. So this deck is, you know, pretty linear, but it has a lot of deck manipulation, a lot of like free hand fix and stuff like that. I think that's the best thing you can go for a budget deck is, again, like bringing up your floor and making sure that those brick games aren't really brick games and you have a chance to recover. It's sort of like the, talked about it in our Konosuba one, but it's sort of like the marker of like what's a budget deck and what's a meta deck, is the meta decks can recover from bad situations and things that aren't tuned and stuff like that can't. So we put a lot of tools in the deck so that you can avoid those situations or recover from them when they happen. So getting into the specific cards, we're going to start with our Field Plus, which is we're just going to run the Kaguya Free Runner. It's a Free Runner and a level 0 bomb, so even if you're going to try a field, it's going to trade with something. Just a general going first plus dodging combat. Only 75 cents, which surprised me because this card goes in the meta deck, but, you know, really cheap, so go out there and grab it. Easy
rare, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Easy $3 add to the deck. And then of course we have the Chica Brainstorm, the Self-Rest Salvage Brainstorm. That's also a 3k, but the drawback being you can't play this card alone. So if you only open this card, which you shouldn't, we're running 18 level zeros, you should have plenty of other level zeros to throw down. But if you do go second, you could throw this down in the front row if you have extra copies. It's a perfectly reasonable beater to throw out there and clear a lane, which is especially nice because our, you know, other main Field Plus is a runner. It's pretty small, even though it's a bomb. So we can beat over stuff with our Brainstorm and then dodge combat with our runner. And it's a Salvage Brainstorm. I'm partial to Salvage Brainstorms. You always know the pool of cards that you're brainstorming into. And this card's an uncommon. It's only 40 cents.
Yeah, I mean, I'm surprised. Yeah, self-tap Brainstorms down to uncommon these days.
Yeah.
I mean, that's good for the budget players.
Yep.
I
mean, moving on. The reason that you'd ever sleeve up bag in current year, the K bag support. It's a global 500 power, and then whenever you trigger a bag, after you resolve it, so whether you take the blind stock or not, and you can pay out the bag, because you're going to pay one, and then you draw a card. So it turns your bags into books, which is, you know, pretty cool. No, you don't always want to pay it out, because sometimes the stock charge is useful, if like you're not going to go to refresh or stuff like that, but if you just want to get that plus, or you're running low in hand, it's just turning your stock charging trigger into a plussing trigger, if you'd like, is a really powerful tool.
Mm-hmm.
Global 5 also helps us sit big with our costless level 1 combo off that same bag. So, you know, sort of dual purpose there. Only 40 cents, just an uncommon. And this other one, the Valet Eye. This is a 3K if you have 3 or less stock. So, you know, pseudo oversize. And then it's a drop salvage. Notably, our level 1 combo is not selective, just ripping cards off the top of the deck. So we need to have something in the deck to give us that selection when we need it. And at a high enough count that we will see it often, see it every game. So a 2 count here for the drop salvager. We're going to be milling a lot because we're, spoiler alert, we're going to run the Chica combo at the top, which means you got to run the check 4 event. So we're going to be filling our grave a lot. So more often than not, our grave will be our toolbox, not our deck. And of course, this card is cheaper than the Ayasaka drop search, which is like $4 or $5 card, even though it's a rare. So this keeps the cost down and gives us some selection as well as an additional field plus.
The price of association there for the drop search. Necessary. Mm-hmm. Necessary evil for the Kaguya finisher.
Yep. Now right here, this double rare, this is the stock swap. Not something you normally see accessible to a budget deck, is a really powerful tool like this. At only $2, you can stock swap your opponent at any point in the game. And then, like we gushed about this card before, but it's the fact that this, when this card sits in your hand or when you pick it up off a Brainstorm Brainstorm or something like that. If you hit extra on your Brainstorm, it's just a card you can grab. It always has value in your hand because Twin Drive is useful no matter what at any point, even if this card is a chumper, even if you never use the Stock Swap effect. A really strong card. Stock Swap is something you need so that your opponent can't just disrespect you and sit on a bunch of stock because you can't interact with it. So having an out to that is really important, even if you're playing something budget. So definitely worth the $2. And then one Climax Swapper, a check top two rearrange. We don't have a way to sort of get into Climaxes other than drawing them, but having a way to swap out, we have a chance to grab this, we will, is always a good tool for consistency's sake. Easy include. Rounding out the level zero and going to level one, we have the Chica Bonder to the Love Detective event. If you've ever played Persona 5 or you've seen it before, it's the, what is it? The calling card?
Same thing. Yep.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so you can check up to four and then bounce a cost zero on your opponent's board if you'd like. It does not have the your opponent must memory a card and then they draw one and stuff like that. That's not it. So it has all the other effects, but you can both bounce your opponent's cost zeros if for some reason your K can't get over them. Because our K is on attack, we aren't punished for bouncing our opponent's characters. If they're too big or they have nasty effects or stuff like that, we want to get rid of them and get rid of our opponent's bombs, things like that. I just get them out of the way and mill through our deck. We're running four of the Chica because effectively the way this works is it's the same as Akatsuki. Mm-hmm. If there's a thing in your grave, because it's the same card economy, you ditch a card, you bond to this, you immediately play this, or the card sits in your hand. In a way, it's even better than Akatsuki because you get the ditch out immediately and you don't have to mill. Mm-hmm. But yeah, the downside is that it eats 8 deck slots.
Yeah, it's Akatsuki at the cost of deck slots post level one.
Mm-hmm.
I am a huge fan of this package as somebody who played Persona 5 for a while. I'm so glad Kaguya has it. The deck speed and the control that you get with this package feels incredibly good. I am attempting to make it work in some sort of meta capacity, but that is to be determined. Keep your eyes open.
And at only $7, I think there's no better package for bringing up a dex floor, because like this is dex speed and dex manipulation all in one, and a ditch out. Like the whole package just brings up the floor of the deck dramatically. Mm. Just by existing.
Absolutely. Yep.
Getting on to the level one combo, it's the Head Tilt K. This is 1,000 power for each of your other characters in your back row. So as long as you have your back row filled, it's gonna be 6K. You have the bag support down 6-5. Then on attack with the combo, gonna swing in at possibly 7-5. You have your old board set up. On attack, check top. As long as it's character, add that to your hand. Pretty simple Massachusetts combo. This combo reads pretty boring, and it's not the most exciting card. But if you think about it, because of the back row, right? Because of the assist, and your other trigger is bar. No matter what you check, as long as it's not the Love Detective event, you're gonna get the plus. Mm-hmm. So as long as you only have four real whiffs on pluses in your deck when you're going for combo, so pretty good. The big thing is that you're gonna sit big, and you can defend this card. This card can challenge standby and then also back up over it. You can like back up to like 8-5. You can like back up over 1/1s with your costless card, which is pretty good. It's the power line of the card that makes it good, not so much the combo. The combo is just an on-attack plus, which is always good.
Yep, agreed.
Simple and effective. All right, other level ones. We got the seasonal uniform change Chica, 1-0, 5K all the time, as long as you're playing Kaguya. And then on-attack Twin Drive. Twin Drive's useful for paying out triggers. If we want to have that stock charge from the bag and then just pay out the bag but not get the plus because our hand's already good, we can just pay that out and just have a stock charge. Pretty cool. Just helps us keep our stock clean and just have an auxiliary level one that we can level for experience, stuff like that, so that we can hit our experience target, experience four. Want to have like a green level three and a yellow level one. Because of the way the Chica finisher works, you're actually pretty okay to level one of your Love Detective events, but you know, you'd rather level something else. So that's why we have this here at three.
Mm-hmm. But and yeah, then, between
go ahead.
I mean, I was just gonna say between this and the level zero stock swap twin drive and the bag support, you have a lot of options in this deck, a lot of ways to keep yourself running clean, keep your stock clean.
Yeah.
Again, raising the floor of the deck.
And then of course, because I said we're trying to protect our K's when we can, we're running two of the 2K backup, 75 cents for the rare. Just an easy include. We want to try to protect our K's if we can. If we happen to get this card early, we'll hold on to it, protect our K's. We can keep looping combo. That's the benefit of a big on attack combo, is when you have an on attack combo that gets big, you're not punished for backing up and defending it because you don't have to have additional targets to reverse, which is something, you know, that's like why the Kirito and what is it, South 10th is considered so strong because it can win lane and then go again. And obviously K's plus isn't as good, but you know, similar concept. Level 2 is pretty light. We got the free fresh counter and the Ishigami support. In terms of supports, you're not always going to want to play this card. That's why it's a one of, but if you want to try to box out your opponent or get some extra power for your Chica finisher, you know, make sure it wins its lane. You can throw this down. It also has the disruptive anti-brainstorm effect. Whenever your opponent hits a brainstorm, you give one of your characters 2K. It can help your K win board even going into level 2, since you can sort of spread your power out. That's sort of the idea. Still not a card you want to play every game, but an important card to have as an option nonetheless. Refresh counter at 75 cents in terms of a card that can really just, you know, win you games you otherwise had absolutely no chance to win otherwise. You can't go wrong with refresh counter. Easy floor include.
Yeah, so super strong, gets you out of rough spots. No reason not to play it.
Yeah, moving right into level 3s, making good pace here today. We got the K early play. It is a 2 or less climax, ditch any card, heal to stock early play. So pretty simple, nothing crazy. But the big thing here is that it's on color and it's cheap. If you want to try to splash more blue or something like that, maybe play a blue plusing 0. You might be able to fit the Hayasaka in the spot. But I think it's important to be on the same color as Shirogane here. Because when you're trying to juggle experience for Shirogane, because Shirogane is such a strong card, sometimes if you have overflow in your color, like you'll level a level 1 yellow card first, or a level 1 red card if we're talking about the meta build or whatever. Like you'll lever your other card first because you know you're going to clock like your green level 3 or whatever so that your experience is set. Because you only need experience 4. So just having your early play be on the same color as Shirogane is just really valuable. So we went with this, as well as keeping costs down since, you know, it's cutting 3 double rays from the deck to play K instead of Hayasaka. It's a very simple early play healer. And then the Shirogane is just way too good into the current meta. The card's $5 each on TCG Player. I know it's a little more on Strictly Broken, but right now there are a ton of sellers on TCG Player where you can get this card for only $5 or less if you look. I saw it as low as 4.
Yeah, it's insane. This card is so strong.
Yeah, this is the card that's like super well positioned into the current English meta. Everybody's playing for board. People are either like playing Kaguya, playing Dao, stuff like that. Your opponent can't back up. You clear the lane, and if it's a pesky card, just kick it to your opponent's clock. Off finisher, like board stabilization, all in one. Extremely, extremely good. Worth the $10 hit to your deck. And then our finisher, Love Detector Chica. Pretty similar to Crystal Song Yukino if you've been playing Weiss for a while. It's going to sit at 11K, going to heal on play. And then when your opponent becomes reversed, you pay 3, ditch 2, and then you perform the following action 2 times. Deal X damage where X is equal to the number of Love Detective events in your grave. So it's important you have your Love Detective events. You play them, you mill out. On your final turn, you set as much damage as you want to do. It's usually going to be 2 or 3. I don't think you ever want to burn 4 twice, but if you want to, you can.
I mean, you can, yeah. But it is really nice to be able to modulate your numbers based on your knowledge of the opponent's deck.
Yeah, if your opponent's pretty compressed, maybe you even want to do burn 1, burn 1. And since you can ditch the cards, both like, you know, it's good to play the cards because they give you mill if you want to set up your deck going to your final turn, or you can just have them in hand and ditch them for the cost. Because you'll pay cost before the effect goes off. So you're able to ditch Love Detective events from your hand, and then they'll work for the combo. I think the sweet spot, though, they're like, you know, barring any weird situation, is probably burn 3. Like, burn 3 sounds really good for pay 3, ditch 2.
For sure.
And then it's off bar, plusing trigger. We have the climax swap in the deck, so the bar will help us do more K combo more often.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know,
shouldn't be a problem to get this this climax into your hand by endgame, considering it is bar and you're running climax swap, so no problem there either.
Whole finisher package is only $9. And again, here's the deck laid out one more time. $45 on TCG Player before shipping for the whole thing. Like, between this and the Konosuba deck, Brian, what do you think? I think this might be better.
Comparing the two decks, I think there are a lot of good cards in the Konosuba deck, but I think the floor of this deck is a lot higher thanks to the Chica package.
Yeah, the Chica package just lets you always have, you know, perfect control over your deck state, which is really valuable. But yeah, $45. You love Kaguya. You're kind of sticker shocked by the new stuff. You want to try it out. Hop on TCG Player, pick it up. It'll come to your door, head to your locals, and make some people really angry with a budget deck that's extremely, extremely good.
this deck could perform pretty well into the general meta, I think.
It follows every tenet of like a decent deck where you have like the high deck manipulation, plusing triggers because you have the you know, the bag support or whatever. They're not the best plusing triggers, and your finisher is on reverse. Those are like the holes in your deck. But you know, you have the Chica package for the deck manipulation, which, you know, adds a lot. God. We keep bringing it back up because it really is that important. But yeah, I think that's it. Usual spiel we do at the end of all of our videos. Card games competitive. If you want to play Weiss, you want to get some games in or just talk to the greater community, definitely check those out. We don't run or operate them, but we are in them, and they're pretty active, so definitely give those a look. Looking to buy, sell, trade Weiss, or look at new JP spoilers that get posted to Global, definitely check out the Facebook communities. Give those a look. And then if you want to try this deck even before you buy it, you can hop on Weiss Fight. Just go to weissfight.net, grab the Encore Decks link from our description, plug it in, make an account, and get on there and just play some games. You don't even have to be in voice chat with someone. You can just hop on there, just like, what is it, Dueling Book here with Yu-Gi-Oh.
Yep, from Yu-Gi-Oh, yep.
If you want to leave feedback for Weiss Fight, definitely check out that Discord link that's also in the description. The developer is really active with sort of responding to feedback and improving the application. So definitely give that a look if you're interested. Anything else, Brian?
I don't believe so. I mean, I'm really enjoying doing these budget decks, though. I think I wouldn't be opposed to doing more of them in the future if people want to see them. So
yeah, let us know. Let us know if you like the budget decks, because I think we have a lot of fun like discussing and brewing it. Like, okay, like, yeah, you know, it's got to be cheaper than $75 because that's the going rate of a booster box. What can we do? And it's sort of a deck building challenge, not only for us, but like, you know, we want to provide something that you know, people can just, you know, get out there and start playing. Best part of the game.
The pack for you, yep.
All right, and with that, Pittsburgh White Schwartz signing off. We'll see you guys in the next one.
Yep, see ya.